Today, we are going to construct our service model, and then you can start do your or set up your platform. Then road alignment design, then also set up all those infrastructure. Have you installed the software? Dah. Okay, here, this is the user interface of AutoCAD Civil 3D. Okay. So here, this one is done. This one is drafting. So in AutoCAD Civil 3D, in AutoCAD Civil 3D, you can shift from AutoCAD Civil 3D to 2D drafting and 3D modeling. You can see here. So we have these three: drafting and annotation, Civil 3D, and drafting and annotation. So Civil 3D that we are going to use today here. So this is the interface. So you can find many service model, set up the platform. The interface is slightly different because I set the aspect ratio of my screen very big, so then because I don't want to I want to make sure that the lettering appear here is not pixelized. Okay. You have installed already, eh? Maybe you can start we work together here. On the top ribbon here, this is the main menu. The main menu here, we have home, insert, annotate for the dimension, also hatching, modify to change, to do modification of our surface, our platform, and then also the road. Okay. Analyze, you can use comment here to do some simple analysis. Okay. Under the home main menu, we have ribbon here. The left most likely is tool space here. So tool space here, this is the window of tool space. When you activate, you can activate the tool space. This window will appear, okay. And then you can deactivate as well. And then inside the tool space here, we have prospector, setting, survey, and toolbox here. So prospector here, all your data. Point cloud, surface, alignment will be listed here. So easy for you to access. Maybe we consider as model explorer here. So alignment, when you construct your road, alignment road, so you will be under the alignment here. Surface, if you have surfaces, so it will be here. Okay. Setting here, if you want to set up the properties of the surface, because you can see here we have surface style, label style, so you can set here. And for also for grading style, how it look like, cut slope, how it look like, so you can manage here under the setting. Under the setting also you can set up piping network, the size of the pipe they want to use. Okay. Okay, perspective here. Okay, you cannot just simply open the AutoCAD civil AutoCAD drawing and then construct the surface. You have to insert the object into the current drawing. So in our case here, drawing one. So we have to insert the AutoCAD drawing multiple polyline that we have. So then, first step, you prepare the surface first, create the surface, and then okay. So you can see here the style is contour 2 meter and 10 meter background. So there is a different here, you can change it to the difference between background and design. Background, the color scheme is monochrome, grayscale, and then the design, the color, the major interval in red, and then the minor interval in green color. So and then this one is 1 meter is the minor interval, and then 5 is the major interval of the contour line. Okay, so currently is you can see here contour 2 meter and 10 meter. So 2 meter the minor interval and 10 meter is the major interval. And then background. So the letter, the color of your contour, the generated surface will be in a gray scale color. So you can change to design. And okay, so you change to design. So you can change also this one if you want to have by block or by grass surface asphalt. So then will be look like real, but you have to have very good what call it graphic card or this one. And the material, okay, sorry, my block. Okay, prospector again. Okay, then the next step is inserting the drawing from the AutoCAD. Where is it? Insert and insert. Insert. Under the insert, you have this button. Insert. So insert block. And then go to more. And then select the file. So the unit in feet currently working in feet. So then so then it will be better if we open the file in drawing in this drawing. Open. Where's the open? Open. We check the dimension, the unit of this one. Annotate, and then where's the dimension? This is the dimension. Line. Dimension. Linear line. I want to check you. Okay. What is the dimension? 10 meter. So it's already in meter. my convert to meter to feed. Yes. Drawing one. That's insert. Okay. Insert. More option. And then browse. Sensitive. Open. Okay, let me follow this one as it is. No need to export first because you want to check the scale, the dimension. So then after that we scale it up. This one is automatically detect in feed. I just ordered. Okay, let me see. Okay, so then you can see here. Insert specify insertion point. So you just simply click any point. And then you can see here because we didn't explode, you didn't select to take the option explode. So once we insert this one, this model, so the model in one piece, one block. And then we check the dimension. Go to annotation, annotate, go to dimension, align. Want to make sure the length is, you can see here, change to fit. So you have to scale it up. 3.048 poles. It's supposed to be 10 meter, right? Right? 10 meter, right? So then, select this one, scale up. How much you need to scale up? Calculator. How big? Scale. 10 divided 3.048. Betul. Aku juga. 3.048. Kan? Okay, then equal to this one. Copy. Alamak. How to copy? Right click. Ini copy. Okay, this one. And then select this one and then scale. S-C-A-L-E. Scale. Specify base point. Okay, any point. Okay, here. And then scale factor. The scale factor is the value that we have previously. Paste. 3.288. Then enter. Where is my enter? Okay. Okay. So then, let me check the length. Supposed to be 10 already. 10. Okay. Done. So then, since you have in one piece, in one block, so easy for you to manage, to check before you continue. Because later, if without changing the scale, so then the volume calculation will be totally different. It's not as correct dimension. Okay, then we already have this one, and then we explode it. Explode. To break it down, break it into different separate line. Can you see here? Separated line. If I'm not mistaken, the elevation of this one is 70. Right click and properties gives you the elevation. Elevation. Oh, I make mistake here. You can see here the elevation is minus 42. So maybe when I insert the elevation, so the model, so this one is not. So then what you need to do if this happen, you can see here, let me open the original drawing, this one, right, open, and then check the elevation, right click. Properties, elevation is 75, right? 75, so it means that you need to have 75 plus 42. 75 plus 42, berapa? 116. Kira lah. Okay, so how to bring it up? Change to the this one, and then move, bring it up. 75 plus 42, berapa?
117.
Yeah.
117.
Wait. Seventeen. Enter. Done. So then go to the top view. Back to the top view. We check the elevation. Right click. Properties. Masih 74.50. Wait, Ctrl Z. Then the rest will be correct. So this is the from the side view. Okay, you can use this cube to rotate. Okay, and then the home icon here to view your model in isometric. And then front view, top view, you can change using this one. Okay, to move from one view to another view. Okay, so then we already have this one. We already have the polyline, multiple polylines that give us the contour. And also we already have the surface. So then we create the surface. This is the next step. But inside our drawing, we have unnecessary information, right? This one. North, and then also the existing jalan. So what we have to do, we switch it off the layers here. You can see here under the layers, this is the existing road. So we switch off. Sorry. The existing road, switch off. So then you can see the road disappear. And then this one is belong to layers construction. So I switch off. So we don't want any other information that not related to surface construction. Okay, so then hopefully it's already complete here. No need have any other changing. But maybe it will be better if we can check whether any other point somewhere on top or the line is not correct line position here. Okay. The space here. Okay, let's say this one is already go to the top view. And then this is the polylines that we're going to use to generate our contour. So under the surface, this is the surface. We have surface one. This is an empty surface. No any contour or surface generated inside the surface. This is the name only. So the surface property, maybe you can change into existing surface. Existing. Okay. And then okay, you can change it to existing. And then under the definition, we have definition right here. The definition button here. So we have contour. Right click and add. Okay. And then maintain all the information as it is. And then okay. And then select all. So select all. Select all. Okay, all you can see here 903 lines are selected. To end the selection, press right click. So you generate the surface directly. Generate the surface. No need to worry about the error here. The error here because it generated because of, you can see here. We don't have data here. We don't have data. But AutoCAD try to match the elevation, the same elevation. So that's why this line, all these lines are generated. Also this one. So we have to edit. After we generate this one, we have to delete. So that's why the error is coming into the this one. Okay. Okay, so then actually we already have the our surface here with the incorrect information here. So we have to edit. Okay, contour you already have. So you can switch off the minor and major line here. You can see this minor line. And then the brown color here is the major line. Okay. After we complete, but we still need the line, yeah, because this one is the line become a boundary to where we have to delete the excess line here. This line is not correct. We don't have this information, right? It's generated randomly. The AutoCAD detect the same elevation line the other side. Okay, so then to edit, if you have this kind of information, so then you have many area to delete. I show you how to edit. Under the definition, we have edit. Okay, under the definition we have edit. Right click and then delete line. But you cannot delete because the style, surface style, is in contour line. So you have to change the surface profile as surface properties. The surface properties, you change the style to contour and triangles. Change to contour and triangles. Okay, here. And press OK. You can see here, change to triangles and okay, then after this you can edit, right click and then delete line. So to delete line here, just select here, you can see selected. Selected. Just press delete. Press my delete. Oh sorry, not delete. Right click to end the selection. I repeat that. Okay, edit here under the definition. There is an edit here, and then delete line. So select. Okay, I just want to distinguish that there is two selection mode. From the left to right. Oh sorry. Left to right in blue rectangular. So then you can select any object within the rectangular only, rectangle. And then you see here, from right to left, dotted line, and then green. So you can, any object crossing the line, crossing the rectangular will be selected. So like this, right? You don't want up to this point. Selected, right click to end the selection, so it will delete. Okay, jump to. Paham tak? Paham sudah. Okay, here. Nah, this one. The SS line. So, you can see here, we still need this information because you want to delete some unwanted. Select right to left. This point. And then, to end the selection and delete. Execute the delete. Right click. Okay. Up to this point, selected, and then delete. Okay, right here, select right to left, selected, and then press right click to end the selection and execute the deletion. Okay, boleh. Here, select from right to left, up to this point. We selected and right click to end and execute the selection. Here, edit. Okay. Boleh. I have to play Zuhur first, and then you continue with the generate the and do editing. Okay.